bed and I stumble to the kitchen. Pour myself a cup of ambition and yawn and stretch and try to come to life. Jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets the traffic starts jumping with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Working 9 to 5. What a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. It's enough to drive you crazy if you let it.
Welcome back to Green Hill News Network. I'm Carson Palmer.
And I'm Kaylee Blanton.
And it's time for the news.
The HOSA leadership team attended the Fall Leadership Conference at Camp Widgiewagon this weekend and took home the Chapter of the Weekend Award.
Both the boys and girls cross-country teams play second in the regional meet on Monday and will advance to the state meet next week.
The second show of Hawk Theater 2022-2023 season takes place this weekend at Hawk Theater and is pleased to present the Jane Austen classic Sense and Sensibility. You can get your tickets on GoFan.
Green Hill freshman boys basketball tryouts will be Monday and Tuesday after football season ends from 4 to 5:30. Everyone trying out must have a current physical.
Green Hill volleyball wrapped up their season during the fall break, reaching the region tournament for the first time in the program history. Lady Hawks finished this 2022 season 24-8 overall.
The next HOSA chapter meeting will be on Wednesday, November 2nd at 8 a.m. in theater.
And it's time for Teachers versus Students, and we have a very special, special day. Welcome back to Teachers versus Students. I'm Carson Palmer, and today we have a very special game. Look behind me. I guarantee you can see a field goal. Our long snapper is Tyler McCown. Our holder is Wesley. Forgot your last name. And our kicker for our student is Caden. And our teacher, the one everyone's been waiting to see and meet, Christian Capozzi. We have Caden kicking first. You get three kicks. Three kicks. He's smiling about it. He's nervous. His knees are weak and his palms are sweaty. Good snap. Oh my gosh. Thank God Tyler got down on that one.
And the snap.
Snap's good. Holds good. And the kick a little to the right.
Left.
Left. Don't make fun of me. He has one more kick. All you need is one kick. Tyler drops. The kick is good! Oh my gosh, he got it! Who knew? Sam Crickmore, watch out. Just kidding. Just kidding. We love you, Sam. All right, the man, the myth, the legend, Christian Capozzi, coming in, a kicker. Capozzi lines up the snap. High snap. He kicks. It's good! Toe-balled it, but hey, it went through. And the kick's good, and we have a winner. Oh, he wants to move it back. He wants to move it back. All right, he wants to kick a 30-yarder. That's far. Holy crap. Tyler McCown with the snap, the hold, the kick. It's, oh my gosh! It looks like a Texas game. Oh, Carson Palmer's gonna pull something if he does that. Thank you for watching Teachers versus Students. Our winner, the teachers.
And now it's time for the weather.
That kick would have been good from 40.
Yeah.
Welcome, guys. It's Nico Duffy back with the Duffy Downpour. I got one question for y'all. Why was the tiny ghost asked to join the football team?
Why?
Why?
I said, I don't know. Tell me.
Because we're going to need a little team spirit. All right, now with the weather. All right, tonight we got a high of 74, a low of 46. It's going to be sunny today. Saturday, it's cloudy, high of 71, low of 53. And Sunday, 60% chance of rain with a high of 67, low of 56. Let's go Green Hill.
That was Nico with the Duffy Downpour. And we had a chance to meet with one of Green Hill football's managers, Cam Clark.
I'm Miss Crosman. I am the sped teacher here at Green Hill. Jeez. This is Cam. Pam is super involved in the football area of Green Hill. Post-graduation, Cam wants to work for a pro team or a college team, either working with equipment or working with the water. Right now, he works with the Green Hill football team as a manager. He works the sidelines at every game. He's in every huddle, passing out waters. He's at every practice. He works very, very hard.
First time I met Cam, it was through my buddy Tyson. He used to be in the Best Buddies. He's being best buddies. I usually hang out with him and Cam at his house.
That's
and then
funny,
we bring the practice
dude.
And then he started being the water boy. And that changed the setting for us. Like it kinda gave us like an organic feeling to be around Cam.
I wholeheartedly feel like Cam's a part of the program, he's a part of the team. I think it's good that kids get to see and interact with Cam because Cam shows a different light than not everybody else sees. Cam's always energetic, he's always happy.
He was the only one that's like happy and jumping. Whenever our sidelines were down at a tough point in the game.
Cam has built relationships with the players and the coaches. After every game, win or lose, you will see Cam hands up, big smile. He is just the biggest supporter of that team.
Him being at practice like means the world. Like he sees us as like big brothers and like best friends. And just knowing like we have that impact on people is it's like mind-boggling.
Do you work hard? Yes, Cam works very hard. His dad hangs out on the sidelines with him, but Cam is nearly completely independent on running the show on the sidelines with the water.
From June and July to like the hottest times of the year, he's out here and it's every 5 minutes he goes from station to station, rotating waters. And even on Friday nights, whenever we have timeouts, he's the first one out there with the crate. He's the first one to refill that crate in between the drives and gets us back out there whenever we need time on Friday.
Our thing is like climb, commitment, like He doesn't miss practice. He went to White County like 2 hours away. He's commitment. He's loyal.
He's funny.
He loves Green Hill. He's our biggest fan, that's for
biggest
sure.
Fan.
Cam is awesome and we are so proud of him. He gives a big woo.
Woo!
Go Hawks!
Great job, Tyler and Kyler. And speaking of Kyler,
it's time for Kyler's Average Mic.
We got the Green Hill Mount Juliet game going on this Friday. And it's time to ask for some score predictions. How y'all doing? Good. All right. What y'all score predictions for the MJ Green Hill game?
300-45.
38-35.
A lot to a little.
A lot to a little.
1-500.
All right.
28-21.
All right.
28-21, won by a touchdown.
How do you even get 1 point? Someone answer me.
21-14 Hawks.
28-21.
35-38 Hawks.
17-21.
2009, that's huge.
2-1.
28-21.
300-12.
We're gonna start over here.
35-28.
I'm gonna have to say 3-0.
58-0.
I gotta say 21-24.
36-30 Hawks.
35-45.
Hawks? Yeah. Y'all better say it.
Hawks by a million, man.
That's what's up.
35-21.
42-35 Hawks.
There we go.
30-21.
All right.
38-20.
35-14 Hawks.
All right.
42-14.
All right.
38-20.
All right.
49-21.
How about you?
16.
27-14. Hawks.
I'm thinking him too. 27-14.
Green Hill by 50.
That's what's up.
Major W Green Hill.
I think we made it full circle. Y'all get it one more time for your Green Hill Hawks. Let's hear it. It's Hawks by 300. See you on Friday.
Time everyone's been waiting for. Coach E.J. Wood.
What's up, Haley?
What's up, guys? Welcome to Green Hill News, right?
And we'll start off with Wilson Central Hillsboro. Coach, what do you got on that?
Yeah, I think Central had a slow start to the year. I tend to lean to the county. And pick our guys before we get a visitor out. But I think I'm going to have to go Hillsboro for this game. They've got some talented athletes, well-coached.
The Donkeys.
That's right. The Burrows, but Burrows. Close enough.
Same thing. Kaylee, what do you think?
I'm also going to go ahead and say Hillsboro. I think, what was it? It was Wilson Central?
Mm-hmm.
I think Wilson Central just hasn't gotten up to that level yet, and I'm going to have to go with Hillsboro.
I got faith in the county. I'm going to go Wilson Central. Just because I kind of live near there. Next, we'll do the White County Sequatchie game. Personally, I think White County is going to win that one. they got, you know, their running back. He's kind of hurt, but he pulls through all the time, so, and pulls his hammy anyway. Kaylee, what do you think?
I actually know absolutely nothing about Sequatchie, so I guess I'm just going to pick White County. Because
other than the fact that it's a great name. Mr. Wood, what do you think?
Squatchy.
Squatchy.
That's how you say it. It's kind of like Lebanon. I'm gonna go White County, man. Malachi Dowell is one of the preeminent rushers in the state, and at some point he was leading in the nation, right here, just down the road in Sparta. And so he has been injury prone this year. I think he had a pretty significant groin injury, and so wish him the best. I just saw a picture come out for his Mr. Football candidacy. If I had a vote, I'd give it to him. He's special. He's slow when he needs to be slow, and then when he's ready to be fast, you can't catch him.
Yeah.
And so I'm going White County.
He has lots of touchdowns.
By a hunna.
By a hunna?
Yeah.
Next, we got Hunter's Lane and Station Camp. Coach, what are your thoughts on that?
So I got to meet Hunter's Lane head coach last year. They came to a region meeting here on the Hill and then ended up coming and playing here as well. I really like him. I really like what they've got going on. They're doing a lot of good things. They're revitalizing that program, putting a lot of money into that program. But after seeing Station Camp last week, that's a 1-4 region team that their record's not indicative of their abilities. And so I'm going to go Station Camp by 2 touchdowns.
Kaylee?
I think I'm going to agree with him. I mean, Hunter's Lane has won 2 games this season, and I don't think Station Camp is going to be make 3. So I'm going to have to go Station Camp.
And now it's time everyone's been waiting for, Mount Juliet Green Hill.
Well, Kaylee, I'd be interested in what you think.
Well, I mean, it's Mount Juliet versus Green Hill. You can't really wear a Green Hill letterman and say Mount Juliet, so I'm going to have to go with Green Hill.
And I'm going to have to go Green Hill as well, just because Hawks by 300.
Yes, sir.
So we've got 2 homers. I'm going to be the realist here and just speak to a little bit about both programs. You know, Mount Juliet, a storied football program, athletic program as it is. We're thankful to be, and I mentioned this on the Hawk Hour last night with Christian, thankful to be in a small community like this, supports our programs, and so it's great. It was great to go over there. Last year, my memory's failing. It was raining. I remember that. I remember some touchdowns both ways, and I think it wound up like 25-21. Isn't that right?
I believe so.
Yeah,
Hawks.
Like
okay.
Yeah, Hawks.
And so, with all of that said, I think it's a formidable opponent, probably our best opponent thus far. I don't know. Let me just Corso it.
It's gonna be Pat Corso. No way.
Let's go home!
And that's all for Green Hill News Network. I'm Carson Palmer.
And I'm Kaylee Blanton. We'll see
you
at the
game.
Have a
great, great weekend.